Hello everybody, my name is Mikola and today I will show you an easy way to make a boost pedal for guitar. This one I've made myself just in few minutes. What is it for? Sometimes you need to increase your guitar volume to make your amp give more distortion and drive. And this thing can drive for sure. That's why I called it boost driver. Boost driver, because it's a booster and a car and it can go for a drive. Not like a vehicle, but it can make you feel the drive. Okay, just let me show you how to make it. How to make a pedal with a four-wheel drive. Okay, now I'm done. Everything starts with 2N5088 transistor. It has three legs and also it has a flat side and convex side. Put it flat side down. Now connect to the transistor two identical 150 nanofarad film capacitors. So the first one connect to the left leg and the second one to the middle. Now we have to connect resistors. Starting with 10K resistor, then 830K resistor, then 360 ohms resistor, and the last resistor 100K. This is the whole scheme of this booster. Now we need to solder here, 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 and here. And here is what we got. Now we need a 100K potentiometer. It has three terminals. I attach wires to each of them. Put it like this. Now its right terminal connect here. And left terminal connect here. Next we need DPDT foot switch push button. It looks like this. And it has six pins. First of all, connecting two lower pins. The only free one, the middle terminal of potentiometer, connecting to the right upper pin of foot switch. And left upper pin connecting here. Now we need two jacks, stereo for input and mono for output. Connect inner or upper lug of mono jack to the same inner or upper lug of stereo jack. Outer or lower lug of mono jack connect to the middle right pin of foot switch. And outer or lower lug of stereo jack connect to the middle left pin of foot switch. Now connect inner lug of mono jack here. And the last step, to attach this to 9V power supply. If you want to use a 9V battery, you can use it like this. Plus connecting here and minus to the middle lug of stereo jack, the only lug that left free. I will use this DC power jack socket. This contact connect to the middle lug of stereo jack. This contact connect here. That's it. Quick test. Everything works right. Now I'm making a primitive insulation with electrical tape. It probably looks not neat, but it works. Now moving on to the pedal enclosure. For a pedal's enclosure, you can use a tin candy box, a box from a craft store or a hand cream container. But you can think outside the box and use something absolutely unpredictable, for example, toy car. You have to dismantle it and to make holes for push button, volume knob, input jack, output jack, and power jack. Before placing everything, I have to disconnect power jack, insert wires to the hole, and connect them again. Now putting everything in place. Fastening wires with insulation tape. If needed, block wheels with super glue, fit the car parts together, and our boost driver is done. Just imagine faces of your friends, if you have them, when they will see this pedal in your pedal board. But besides, this pedal is very original and beautiful, it is also a real working booster. If you liked this video, subscribe to my channel and leave a comment with your ideas. Make rock, not war. And drive safe.